Ladies and gentlemen, how do you pronounce your whole name?
It's Bobak.
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 Ladies and gentlemen, Bobak, and today he's got a hanger that helps straighten your clothes. Ladies and gentlemen, Bobak.
Great. Thanks for coming, guys. Let's give a round of applause to the kids that are here. I think it's awesome that the parents have brought their kiddos. I wish my dad had brought me to this event, so future generation. So who here loves to iron? No one. Oh, actually, you do. Okay. It relaxes you and you got a boy here. Well, I hate to iron, right? And so when I do, here's a typical t-shirt. When I take it out of the washer and dryer, right, especially if it's at the bottom of the hamper, usually it comes out looking like this, right? Now, I can't wear this to work, and I don't want to iron it. So then, oftentimes, if it's one of my favorite articles of clothing, maybe the wife will take it to a laundromat. You pay 99 cents or $2 to get it pressed. But, you know, that can add up. So what I wanted to do is I wanted to come up with a way where I could turn this, right, this wrinkled shirt, into something like this, right? This is the same shirt. It went through the same wash, dryer. But using my hanger, it got most of the irons out. Is it perfect? Is it as good as it being ironed? No. But could I wear it to work? I think so. So how does it work? Let me show you. I created the wrinkle-out hanger. So this hanger will turn that first wrinkled shirt into the one without the wrinkles. In order to show you how it works, I need a volunteer. I need a beautiful volunteer. Anna, why don't you come up here? You didn't know I was going to do that to you, did you? Yeah. So, the way it works is, so this is the shirt that you want to, sorry to do this.
That's yeah. Okay.
So this is the shirt that you want to de-wrinkle, and this is my hanger. So, if you could pretend to be my, yeah. So basically what you do is you simply just put the shirt that you want to press, if you will, over the hanger, right? Now there's a magic. Remember that bar that was inside? That bar comes off and it's 200 grams of polished steel that's magnetically attached. So what you do is you just simply reach in and you take that bar off. Once the bar is off, it'll split into two. Each one of these is 100 grams. You simply put one in the bottom front of the shirt and another one behind. It snaps closed, and then you just kind of got to, like, you know, just tug it so it's, you know, kind of stretched. Oh, this is an older version. The new ones are P52 magnets or stronger, or N52, sorry. Anyway, so once you hang it, and then if you'd like, you can mist it with a little bit of a water. 4 hours later, this shirt will look like this. And it works on shirts, blouses. You can use two bars if it's for pants, whatever you want. So the good news is, you know, the cost to manufacture it in the US, the whole thing all in is less than $350. So I'm looking to wholesale it for $750, retail it for $1499. And if you guys vote for me today, preferably first place, that $1,000 will go to a little bit of it to Robert O'Neill, who's my CAD guy, to make one small change to the CAD, and then to Bill Dickinson from DeMar Plastics, who's going to help me with the manufacturing. So I really could use your vote. I need that money to bring this to Bed Bath & Beyond, Walmarts, and Targets everywhere.
Question?
Yes, I'm done. Thank you.
Is it the weight that straightens it out?
Yeah, exactly.
So you're hanging your trousers from the cup.
I missed the last part.
They have a hanger that grabs your trousers right at the cuff.
Yeah.
And you leave your wallet in it because the wallet is always heavy.
Okay.
Bunch of keys.
Same concept. Same concept. Probably better because that one's free. Yeah. Mine's $14.99. But yeah, but same concept. So I used like heavier rods and that was like kind of tugging.
Magnetic, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Let me show you. Your arm's not getting tired,
no.
Is it? Thank you. And then so there's four magnets inside. Robert and I, we did a lot of different tests, and it turns out that 6mm by 2mm P or N52s work great. And I really wanted to have the rod look like a typical, you know, the pant rod. I didn't want it to be some big, thick diameter thing. So fortunately, with the right gauge of steel, we got the 200 grams that we needed in order to And if it's like a heavier shirt or like pants, you can put, let's say, one here, right? And then you could put one below if you wanted to.
Do you need one for the cuffs? I mean, for the...
So a great point. So the patent that we filed, there's a version that has shorter rods that attach to the ends. And so if you wanted to, like for a long sleeve shirt, you put one on the left sleeve, one on the right sleeve. Great question. Great questions. Yeah. Any other questions before we bounce?
More questions.
Yeah. Have you tried this to patent it?
So I filed for the utility patent, and so we're hoping to get the patent on, a hanger with a removable pant bar. So we believe that part to be novel, and then there's some design patents as well for this kind of design. Thanks, Anna, for this design as well. And there's also an electric version that's in the patent, which we haven't prototyped yet, but it uses an electromagnet where it'll actually press the shirt as it rolls down. There was a question in the back, yeah. They're chrome plated, so that should prevent it. And to your point, I would need to do more tests, but I think it shouldn't because it's because of the plating. Yes?
How do you spell your name?
It's Babak, B-A-B-A-K is the first name.
And B as in
Victor? No, B as in boy. Yeah. If you have a vote sheet, you can just circle winner, the third one. My name is right there, yeah. Just kidding. Any more questions? No? Thanks, guys. I appreciate your time.